Good morning, Arcadia!
Welcome to another amazing episode of Apache News. I'm Eric Rogan.
And I'm Dustin Wong.
Now let's get on that news. Congratulations to the following students for winning at the district level for Reflections. Rhiannon Yi took second place for dance choreography, Helen Cho took third place for literature, and Nathan Cho took third place in the music category. Good job.
If you entered the Reflections project and want your certificate and entry back, please come to the front office and claim them by Friday, January 21st, or else.
Are you good at throwing balls? Come prove it at Arcadia High's intramural dodgeball tournament. Here's Albert and John to get you pumped up.
That's too much. All right? Stop.
Well, I'm definitely going to get in on that action.
Me too. But now it's time for some real sports with Billy and Lions.
What's happening, guys? My glasses, that's what's happening. Are you ready for some sports? Oh, yeah!
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 Yeah! Yeah!
Okay, Apaches, pass the Bulldogs. Let's go! Yeah!
They beat them 2-0, just like Michael Vick. Just kidding. But way to blow in the fourth quarter, Michael. But on Friday, they lost to Burbank, losing 1-4. Oh, well.
But with every loss comes a tie, and girls' varsity soccer tied 2-2, winning against Burbank on Friday.
I meant tie.
Oh, yeah! Right, I'm not picking favorites here, but it's time for the Robbie Haynes Show. That's right, it's time for some boys basketball. I'm going to throw off to you, Kev. Yeah!
Well, hi there. I didn't see you there. We were just studying for finals again in college. But do you know what's more important than finals? My boys versus Pasadena.
The boys start off the night right with a shot by Kieran. And one, followed by beautiful layups by Tony and CJ. And here comes CJ again from way downtown. Then we have Robbie. And Robbie. And Robbie. Jeff. And Robbie again. Then the boys finish off the night right with a save by CJ. And a layup by Jeff. But they still lost 51-60 to Pasadena. Good luck next time, boys. But the boys of Arcadia beat Burroughs on Wednesday, 57-52. Good job, boys. Too bad we weren't there to record that game.
I'm Kevin Ewing, and that's it for boys basketball. Back to you, Billy and Lions.
Boom, boom, baby.
It was going in.
Thanks, Kev. Girls varsity basketball suffered a loss against Pasadena, losing 48-52. Better luck next time, ladies.
Well, that's all for this week, Apaches. Time to get swole.
Again!
Oh yeah!
Yeah! Ah, you gained some weight!
Oh, and shout out to John Vandenbosch! I said you can!
Parking permits are now available for spring. Permits will be given out at a lottery during lunch on Tuesday, January 18th at the Rally Court. Your ID card must be present, and unclaimed permits will be sold at 1 p.m. on Friday, January 21st, so make sure you're there. Enforcement will begin on Monday, January 24th.
Live Oak Library's Teen Book Club is meeting on Monday, February 7th at 6 p.m. to discuss The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins. Sign up at the checkout desk to borrow the book.
Live Oak Library is also hosting a video game night every fourth Monday of the month at 6 p.m. Everyone ages 10 and up is welcome to join in on the fun.
The ASB shirt design contest has been extended to January 21st. The design must be only one color and only front or back. Please submit designs to ASB office for a chance to win a $50 AMX gift card.
After the stress of finals, ASB has come to save the day with Spirit Week.
Shut up!
Oh yeah, I forgot you're losing.
Yeah, shut up!
What?
Really?
You know I wouldn't be surprised, but this is what happens when you sell your Xbox 360 for a Super Nintendo.
It's vintage, alright?
You know there's a difference between vintage and broken?
Martin Luther King Jr. Day is coming up this Monday, and I know you're all excited to skip some school, but there's more to it than that. So let's go take some time to honor a great man.
At this time, I have the honor to present to you Dr. Martin Luther King.
I know a man.
A man who walked proud.
A man who stood tall.
A man who spoke strong.
I know a man
who encountered many battles.
They fought against him with brute force. But he fought back with words.
Words of love and peace.
Words of children hand in hand.
In his conquest, he cherished the joy of victory.
And suffered the agony of defeat.
When a voice of violence was called out,
he responded with peace.
When hatred and rage started to burn,
it was extinguished by his love and smile.
I know a man who marched and rallied with his people.
Soon others of different colors followed.
Together, hand in hand.
From city to city, these words grew.
From state to state, his words became stronger.
These words spread throughout, sweeping away Jim Crow.
Breaking down the walls, joyfully, for freedom.
Even today, these words are within the pride of every individual.
These words are taller than any mountain,
stronger than any bullet.
And with these words, we will be able to speed up that day.
When all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and singing the words of the old Negro spiritual. Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Speaking of cultural advancement, there has been some controversy brewing over Huck Finn's use of language. Let's go to Kate for more.
Thanks, guys. A lot of you have already heard about the new controversial release of a censored version of Mark Twain's Huckleberry Finn, in which the N-word is replaced by the word slave. Here's what a couple of students had to say about it.
I think because the N-word has this really racist connotation to it, so if you change it to slave, it kind of tones it down.
I think it can help us like move past the word as being an offensive thing and so that it doesn't have to carry any weight any longer.
I think that the N-word being used in it makes it more realistic in the situation of the book, but for our African-American students reading this book, it could offend some because the ER version of this word is really offensive.
Although there are ardent supporters to both sides of the debate, it seems, at least at Arcadia High School, that there is a far greater number of students opposing the printing of the new book than supporting it. In fact, in a poll taken of 305 English students, only 17 supported the reprinting of the book, while 287 students opposed it. So what do some of our wise and esteemed teachers have to say about it?
I don't think that those of us in the majority can fully understand the effect, the emotional impact of that word, especially having it come out of the mouths of people who are not black. On the other hand, I probably would not choose to teach that book.
I'm concerned about the slippery slope, which is what's the next step after that? I mean, we really are turning into Fahrenheit 451. Do we start putting pants on Michelangelo's David because it's inappropriate? Do we start painting Renaissance masters with clothing on them because the women weren't dressed in it? I mean, where do we draw the line?
So where do we draw the line in Arcadia? That's for you to decide. But no matter which version you're reading, Huckleberry Finn will remain one of the greatest American novels of all time. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Kate. Attention! Peer tutoring will not be available after school next week. So have fun studying at home. By yourself. Good luck.
To all juniors and seniors who haven't finished the swim survival test, testing has been scheduled at the AHS swimming pool from 12:30 to 1:30, Wednesday through Friday next week. Come in a swimsuit and bring a towel and your ID card. Remember that you must pass to graduate, so act fast.
Hey Eric, you came over from Britain, right?
No.
Well, anyway, they did a movie about your ancestors. Here's Tiffany Wu for more.
Hi guys, so last week I went to watch The King's Speech, and I loved it. So The King's Speech centers around Bertie, King George V's son, who is played by Colin Firth. After his father's death and his brother Edward VIII's infamous abdication, Bertie seeks to succeed the throne. Unfortunately, Bertie suffers from a speech impediment. With Britain on the verge of war and in need of a leader, Bertie's wife finds an unorthodox speech therapist, Lionel Logue, who, with his unconventional methods, finally treats Bertie's stammer. Yes, the plot is predictable, but the combination of director Tom Hooper's handsome lighting, beautiful photography, as well as screenwriter David Seidler's powerful words make Bertie's quest to find his voice a journey worth going through.
Jack and Jill
went up the hill.
Went up the hill. Who put her in? Little Tommy Tim. Da! Ma! Ba!
And up comes your Royal Highness.
All right, Bertie.
Yes.
It's actually quite good fun.
Most importantly, the film is filled with masterful performances by Colin Firth, Jeffrey Rush, and Helena Bonham Carter, all of whom are nominated for Double G's. Colin Firth's humorous yet dignified take on King George VI, or Bertie, earns him not only a Golden Globe, but an Oscar. Also, Jeffrey Rush's witty and eccentric performance as Lionel Logue makes the bromance all the more heartfelt.
I believe sucking smoke into your lungs will kill you.
My physicians say it relaxes the throat.
They're idiots.
They've all been knighted.
Makes it official, then.
All in all, I think the 7 Golden Globe nominations speak for themselves.
And you put that woman in our mother's suite!
Your mom's not still in the bed, is she?
That's not funny.
So, I urge you all to go watch The King's Speech before award season starts.
Thanks, Tiff.
If you liked our show, text AWESOME to 626-872-4040.
If you thought we could do better, text AWESOME to the same number.
And if you want to see us party right now, text JUST DO IT.
Got this.
Kevin, explain what's going on here.
Okay, so what's going on now is Aaron is going to get tied up and we're going to carry her back.
Good idea.
Four. Five.